segregation and the legalized oppression of black people was a continuation by the white South of the Civil War. That's exactly what it was. It was taking out on black people their venom against the white Northerners and saying, you may think that you took our way of life away from us, but you're wrong and your foolish social theories are wrong too. So it was a continuation of the Civil War, there's no question about it. In the early 50s, America was a horribly segregated country. It was as if the whole South was a rotten fruit that everybody could smell. There were a couple of notorious lynchings in Mississippi. A black kid named Emmett Till whistled at a white woman, and they killed him. Black guy named Mac Charles Parker, who was accused of having raped a white woman, taken out of jail, killed, thrown in the river. I think both those guys were thrown in the river. Blacks were routinely pulled out of cars and beaten up by state troopers all throughout the South. Black poverty was just horrible. It was being shown in magazines. And then the Supreme Court decided that it was unconstitutional for states to run segregated school systems. And little cute, clean, starched black kids began to show up on people's television screens, being walked to school by their parents, and screamed at by white people. The contrast could not have been more stark. The white people who were screaming were, the caricature is the people, working class people, you know, not terribly clean, some of them obese, faces distorted with anger, screaming obscenities at 6-7 year old children. Well, television was new, everybody was glued to it. That was one. Two, the country had fought this fight for democracy. Blacks felt it, whites felt it, and blacks were restless. They just, sitting on the back of the bus, being relegated to the upper floor of a theater, and sometimes to only one row of a theater. Going to a gas station when your bladder was full and not knowing whether you'd be permitted to use the bathroom, having white people be just as rude to you as they chose to be, giving you absolutely no respect, not being able to try on clothes that you bought at stores, all of that stuff, and worse was going on. And Northerners knew it, and they had tried kind of to avoid it, but when blacks started taking their children to school, the North could no longer avoid the stinking, rotting fruit. And the South was represented by some of the most unattractive people in the Congress. Senator Theodore G. Bilbo of Mississippi was just an awful human being. And there were a lot of Southerners in the House who just spewed bile. And so the North couldn't see it anymore. And blacks began to get hope from the fact that the Supreme Court had finally said, and blacks interpreted this 54 decision to mean the Declaration of Independence and the Constitution include us. Just as we've always said, all God's children are equal. And so we started to move. And white people thought, that's right. And a lot of white people joined in. You couldn't say that you wanted integration to be all mixed up because the white Southerners kept on saying, well, all I want to do is sleep with white women. They say, no, we don't want to sleep with white women. Keep your darn women. They're not that cute anyway. We don't want them. What we want is good educations for our children. And I think that integration for us meant freedom from oppression. I don't think that black people really thought of joining the country club or this or that. They thought, get rid of this humiliation. first of all, get some equal education for our children. That everybody knew. That was a goal. Get equal education, brother, because that's our future. But don't tell me I can't go to the bathroom anymore. Don't tell me I can't sit anywhere on the bus or in the theater. Don't tell me that. It's just too terrible. I don't think it was a positive thing. I just think it was get rid of all of this oppression. The main concrete thing that we hoped would happen would be that our kids really would get equal education. That was enormously important. The second thing that people wanted very much was public accommodations. I mean, you cannot understand how horrible it was to have to contemplate a trip south. And the third thing was freedom from fear of being injured in the South. But a trip to the South for a Northerner was fraught with peril because you were worried that your car would run out of gas and some person would be violent to you and you have no recourse to the law because the law was totally unfair. And then once you got to the town where you were going to be, if you had made arrangements to stay with friends because you couldn't stay at the local hotel, and there was often no public place to eat. Well, we want to be rid of all of that stuff. Beyond that, I don't think many people had a vision. If I thought about it, I would have thought that white people's bad views of black people are based on ignorance. And when we get together, they will cease to be ignorant about us, and they will, the scales will fall from their eyes, and they will begin to be decent. That's what I thought. I was pretty naive, but that's what I thought. Black people were always super Americans. We had to believe in America more than other people did. In order to have any hope, in order to live, in order not to go crazy. We had to believe that the 13th, 14th, and 15th Amendments meant something, and that the Declaration of Independence, though written by a slave owner, did mean the full scope of the words. So once we had the opportunity to make it work, we went full bore at it. And besides, we had this terrible itch of the humiliation in our daily lives that we wanted to get rid of. But we also had something else, and that was a very powerful faith in the decency of white people. I no longer have that faith, but we had it then. And that was, if we can only demonstrate to white people how rotten this system is, most of them will change, and the country will change very rapidly. I think that gave us our discipline, and that faith, both in the country and in the decency of white people.